When you begin to believe that you are worthy of blessings, blessings will come your way. When you ask for God to help you through a situation, God will say, I will help you when you begin to help yourself. The time angels and spirit guides come in to assist you in your journey is when you show them that you're ready and you want their help. There will be no divine being from angelic realms, places that are light and love, that will forcefully put their input into your life because they follow the law of free will. When you're going through something and you can't get through it, the only way to do it is through the power of the mind. You can heal physical ailments, mental ailments, anything that you're going through, relationships, problems. The power of the mind gets you through it and time. Nothing happens overnight. It takes us a little bit in order to process and to train our brain and to get it from feeling one way to another. It will take repetitive, positive affirmations, believing you deserve it. That's a big one. A lot of people don't believe they deserve happiness. They don't believe they deserve abundance or wealth or health or well-being. Maybe they're used to living a life of sadness and having things go wrong for them. And so they keep it in their mind that that is what their world's going to be. And so I went through that energy for a while. And then once I started to see that I deserve love, I deserve to be treated right, I deserve abundance, I deserve security, health, well-being, things started to go better for me, and they get better every single day because I tell myself that it gets better every day. Sometimes when we go through struggles and we can't get past something, we have to remind ourselves of how worthy we are, because our lives have been a series of people telling us that we're not worthy, we can't do it, we shouldn't do it that way. We have all types of societal lies happening with us, you know, television, social media. A lot of us are going through a situation where we're breaking free from that. And so it can be difficult at first because you're going to learn yourself all over again. You know, this is where the concept of death of the ego, death and a rebirth, you're going to be learning yourself all over again. You have to learn who you truly are and forget about who you were taught you were your whole life, because that is not who you really truly are. Who you really truly are is something bigger than you'll understand until you start to want to understand it. And see, and that is exactly the point. And so spirit, the universe, God will not try to force you to understand something or try to force you to take that next step in your advancement or ascension or awakening, because you have to be ready for it. You know, it's something that is not easy. It could be at first so difficult that you want to give up, but if you keep going, you keep continuing, you pay attention to the signs and you listen to the intuitive nudges that you get, and you really, really, really stick by this journey. And most of all, out of everything, you must have faith. You have to have faith. Without faith, without believing, you know, blessed is the soul that believes without seeing, and blessed is the soul that has faith without it happening yet, right? So that's what faith is. Believing and having faith is not seeing it, but knowing that it's real. For some reason, you just believe it's real and you know it's going to happen. And so I want you to believe in yourself first, because everyone around you could believe in you, but if it's you not believing in you, what's the point, you know? Don't look for it outside of love. Don't look for it inside of other people. Look for it inside of you, because inside of you is a magical being just waiting to come out and play. And we got to remember to have joy in life. Don't take things so seriously. Sometimes I can have that issue being a Virgo. I tend to overanalyze everything and say, well, am I doing that right? Am I doing that right? Or, you know, guilt and shame is another big one. You guys got to let go of that. And forgiveness. And you could say I forgave someone, but really you haven't. Because if it's still affecting you and it's affecting your relationships now, affecting your friendships, it's still lingering. And you have to clear and cleanse that. There are many ways to do that. Through meditation, through prayer, practicing forgiveness every day. I forgive. I really want to forgive. Please help me forgive. Spirit guide, show me how to do this. They will work with you. You just have to ask for help, you know. They will wait for you to be ready. You just have to be ready. And when you are, trust me, they'll be right there waiting for you. Call on your angels and call on your spirit guides when you're ready. They're ready. Love and light.